I am a mountain, I am a tall tree, oh, I am a swift wind, sweeping the country. I am a river, down in the valley, oh, I am a vision, I can see clearly, feeling my energy, who I am. Just stand up tall, in your face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain to keep up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope in my back.
Yes, 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 yes. Friends, this is the last section for today, and we are looking at vision. Now, one thing I like about this song is that "World's Greatest" by R. Kelly is that. Now, you know, this song was played in favor of Muhammad Ali. Now, it is said that Muhammad Ali was saying that he is the greatest, world's greatest, way back before he even became world's greatest. Yes, he started saying he saw the future. And that is what we call vision. Now, almost all the great entrepreneurs that we see, they saw the vision. Do you understand? Before it even happened. Yes, now, let's even come to Ghana. This man, Osei Kwame Despite, where you see, yes. Now, this man saw that he would be successful way back before he became successful. Now, so let's see. So he went to Nigeria, right? Because Ghana was hard, isn't it? But that's how we have been programmed, that if your country is fit, you need to travel. Yes. So that was a good move. But he came back when the Nigerian government then sack all the Ghanaians or whatever to their country. Ghana must go in 1983. So when he came back, of course, he was known as Despite, yeah? He was known as Osei Kwame. When he came back, then he told himself, despite the poverty, I didn't go to school, my uncle is not having money, my brother has not traveled, this. Despite all these things, I will still make it. I will be successful. Lo and behold, he became. And he's now the 8th richest person in Ghana now. The most successful entrepreneur in Ghana now. If I said, I don't mean he's the richest, no. Yes, despite. Now, he's typical example of success. Because some of us, yes, we cry, your brother has opportunity, your uncle has this, he won't help you, there is no, yes. But this man passed through all these things, but he became successful. Success leaves clues, guys. Guys, let's take this thing serious. So, 3 M's, we mimic, we model, and we master. So, if someone has been able to do it, why can't you? Guys, so vision is so important. So, even the adversities, upon all the adversities, see yourself that definitely you make it. Okay. So, that's what Muhammad Ali said. And truly, truly, he became successful. Okay. So, let's see. Vision. So, what then is vision? So, vision is what the faculty or state of being able to see. It's not any person at all is able to see the future. No. That is why anytime I talk about these things, I talk about the Asian leaders. So, when I visited Dubai, I started to do some research to read about the current ruler of Dubai, who is also the vice president of the whole UAE, Sheikh Maktoum. Now, it is said that he succeeded his father. Now, his father, whom they refer to as a founder of Dubai, now he put up vision. He said that no, this is the vision we want Dubai to follow. We want to transform Dubai and transform the society, the people. And truly too, 20 years down the lane, look at Dubai now. Extremely successful. So, if you have a leader who has vision, who is visionary, now all his subordinates will also be successful. It is not only the leader who will be successful, the subordinates too. That is why in Dubai now, if you go to Dubai, there is no way you see an Emirati who is poor. Yes. Because Dubai is not just nice or beautiful. The people, the Emirati themselves, they are also successful. If you go to Singapore, the same way, you will not see any Singaporean who is not having a job or whatever. Yes, you can check and see. Almost everybody is employed in Singapore. Yes, of course, you see some people who are these Indians, Malaysians, who are, but I'm talking about the real Singaporeans. So you see, one thing Africans, we can learn is that we need to treat our own people well. When it comes to some of these things, I don't know whether some of our leaders are visionless or whatever. And when I say leaders, I'm not even talking about political leaders or like the president. No, it starts from the home. Your small family, they have entrusted small properties in your family to you. What are you doing? Visionless. You see, it's so sad. The kind of country we are. And all these things has come as a result of greediness and selfishness. We want everything for ourselves. So even if the people suffer and die, we don't care. Yes, that's where we've got to. Because we don't have vision. These Asians. Now, why is it that one Indian person will travel to America or UK or whatever before you realize they formed a community? And these Ghanaians, when you go, you see them. You think that all the Indians, they just got up. No, it started with one person. But Ghana man. He wants everything for himself. So that when he comes home, everybody will bow. Shame. Yes. Because we don't have vision. Challenges. Decisions, thank God I've been there. They have vision. Yes. Even in Ghana, look at the Asians who are here, these Lebanese, they look at them. You can go to their shores. Because they have vision. Yes, I have my own vision. I have 20-year vision. But Ghana, we even supposed to have a 50 years, 30 year plan, vision where Ghana wants to go. So any president, whoever comes, will follow that. Yes, I know the US, they have that, UK, they have that, but Ghana, do we have? So when one political wins power, everything is for that political party. The next day, another political. My goodness, we don't even know where we are going. And I'm not only talking about political, even the home. You see? Because before Ghana can be transformed, the people must be transformed first. So the family has small land or whatever. Then you see the leaders, the leaders of that family, eating with their left, right, center. Work everything to themselves. Then the people should. And you, they, and what pains me is that some of these people, oh my goodness. And I always mention Asians anytime I'm talking about this. They have vision. They think about people. That means we think about ourselves. We become too hypocritical. That we hate our own people. Your own blood, you hate your own blood, but you pretend you love that person you don't know. Oh, goodness. Let's move on. Okay. So where there is no vision, there is no hope. Yes, where there is no vision, there is no hope. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon table that he may run it. Habakkuk 2:2. Yes, I don't talk about religion, I don't talk about culture, but sometimes I make reference. So Habakkuk 2:2, write the vision. Do we have vision And now if I say we are not only talking about the government, the president, you as an individual, do we have leaders, families, small businesses? Do we have vision? Where there is no vision, I like this one, the people perish. Another Bible verse, Proverbs 29:18. Where there is no vision, the people perish. So if you live in a family and the head doesn't have vision, you will definitely perish. If you live in a country, your president doesn't have vision, you will perish. It is what it is. Yes. Do we have vision? Where are we going now? Most successful businesses, the moment you enter there, you see vision statement, mission statement. Of course, mission statement is taken from the vision statement. The goals, everything is taken from the vision. So if your head is not having vision, you are going to suffer. Yes, it is what it is. Yes, so I like this image. So drive. That's the vision, that's the cap there. He knows he will get there, but he has to see it first. Having a vision provides a sense of purpose and direction for the business. Your vision will help you define your short and long-term goals and guide the decision-making along the way. A leader has the vision and conviction that a dream can be achieved. Yes! So where you have vision, then your dreams can be achieved. So it's important, guys. Have vision. Have 20-year plan, 50-year plan. Yes! When there is no vision, you are going to perish. Okay, so we'll be right back.